going, everyone, and welcome back. For those that are subscribed to the channel, I really appreciate all of your support. And for those of you that are finding my channel for the very first time, welcome. Here is the quarter scale Iron Man Mark I Maquette by Sideshow Collectibles, based on the smash hit Iron Man movie. This piece is every bit as great as the movie was. I'm a fan of simple bases and letting the collectible speak for itself. Sideshow has kept the base very simple along with the pose. Don't get me wrong, I love a dynamically posed figure, but there is something to be said about a timeless stance. The paintwork, sculpt are all top-notch. I know that Sideshow produces statues for budget-friendly collectors, but this guy is anything but a budget statue. Sideshow's earlier works, including this one, have something special about them. Something that screens more art than sales, more craft than meeting deadlines. I also have their Mark II and Mark III maquettes, and they are on par with this guy. The light-up feature on the Mark I is there, but you will have to use two AAA batteries. Even though I have all of my other statues or figures that can be hardwired, I rarely use the light-up function. It's nice to have, but seems more like a novelty than a necessity. I do like having the option if I want to. Having a choice between batteries or USB light-up, I take USB all day. Those are some of the major turnoffs about Queen Studio pieces, but they do some fantastic work. I would like to go back and pick up the Mark VI and Mark VII someday by Sideshow, but space is an issue, as we all can relate. Plus, they didn't finish the line in making the Mark IV and Mark V. I highly doubt Sideshow will revisit this line. That is a huge problem with companies. They rarely complete lines. They continue to make the same 3 to 5 characters over and over again. Okay, side ran over. The detailing with the flamethrower and all the gadgets on the back of his suit are here too. I also forgot to mention that this maquette is heavy, easily 25 pounds plus. I only wish that the Mark I received more screen time in the movie. This is my second favorite suit right after the Mark II and followed up by the Mark III. It's pretty much the same suit except the paint job and the missing rivets. Thank you for checking out this segment. If you found anything helpful or enjoyed yourself for a few minutes, please consider subscribing to the channel. And as always, you could find me in the next episode.